Let's see, we gotta get all this stuff off of here. Off of there. Now I gotta get these two bolts back here. So that's those. Does that need to go? Let's see if that will slide up. That's off of there. Is that going to be on? Yeah, I'm reckoning that's going to be up there too, isn't it? That one's already been loose. Which means someone's probably already been in here. What else has this thing held down? Are the screws back here? Oh, there's two more screws back there. Means there's gonna be eight of them holding it down. So that's hopefully got those out now, so this should be loose. Yep, it's loose. That's loose. That's loose. Now I just gotta get the throttle body hose off. Try to. Over there. About always cover the intakes up. Keep anything from falling down in there. Now, you're going to need to get that one pulled up. Well, that's going to be very impractical, isn't it? What's the next step then? Try to get this line loose, try to get that off. Getting this off should be the easiest. Should be. Doesn't necessarily mean it is. Okay. So that one's out of there. Now, can I get that released? Well, thank goodness something came apart. Now, will there be enough room in there? Set that over there. Make sure those screws are the same length. And they are. Sound, isn't it? That's got those loose. So now that's off, that's off. Now I'm just got trying to wiggle this thing up out the hole. There we go. The injector rail is up. And that's a good thing. So that right there should be the injector in question. And of course that one back there left the damn O-ring down there somewhere. Now, See about getting this thing unplugged. That doesn't sound very good out there, does it? Now I gotta get this lock up. Locks. Always a problem, aren't they? Everywhere you turn in this industry, there's a stupid lock on something. There's that. I gotta get a rag to put on down here. Good old red shop rag. Okay, I got that loosened up. Now, let's see if I can get under here, lift that up while I push that down on the can. See if that slides out of there now. Got that loose. Now, let's get in here and move this clip. Slide that out. Now I gotta try and get this injector out. And of course that's easier said than done. It'll come out of there eventually. And then I get to go back in there and dig the O-ring out of the hole. Because it did not want to come out with it. Put that back for safekeeping. Now I've got a new injector. I usually use a little bit of automatic transmission fluid on O-rings, fuel O-rings that is, and that's probably going to fall over somewhere. Let's see about getting some transmission fluid in there. There's that. And there's that. Now that latch didn't go all the way down yet, so we've got to do something with it. And before I get carried away, I've got to get this lined up in that slot. Put it back on there. And that's on there. I'm going to push that on and make sure it's all the way on. And then snap that in. And that's done. One semi-interesting thing right there is kind of a sharp edge there that could run it, rub into metal. It's not doing it, but it could. Wiping the creeping crud off of it. Make sure the new injector tip looks like the old ones. Now that should be ready to go down in there. And like I said, I didn't have to take that off because it comes up with the fuel rail. So we'll put that lock back down in there. And I guess I really didn't have to take that out either. I just had to unplug it, but we're gonna leave it loose for the time being because it might make it easier to do some of our work. Now back to the ATF. Does anybody else notice that the modern automatic transmission fluid stinks? It's never smelled exactly great, but it just really stinks anymore. And the more high-tech it is, the worse it smells. Okay then. So that's back on there. And that'll hopefully stay. Get the crud off my fingers. Now, everything looks kind of halfway cruddy right there. Well, let me see if these things will go the other direction though. Well, this slid down in there remarkably well. Now I gotta find my ratchet and socket. Just get a little snug on, I'll go back and look at the torque spec. That's probably close to it right there, but we'll see in a little bit. I wanna get these lines and stuff hooked back up. Let's see, that one's fine because we already latched it back down. This one goes right there, and this plugs up to it. Nice little click. Now I gotta get that fuel line. Snap it on in two places. I had it click there. Click there and click there. And we're gonna go like this. And back like this. And those will be locked on. Good to go, good to go. So now I gotta go find the torque specs on those, and then I'll have to decide what to do about gaskets and intake replacement and all that good junk. It was 89 inch pounds is what it is, and I was pretty close to it. Yep, that's that. So we'll leave that right there. We'll get back up on this thing and see about replacing that now. This out of the way. wiping this off, making sure it's nice and clean. And you always want to wipe away from the hole. I got a feeling somebody's been here before me, because there's supposed to be a little baffle that covers this, and it is AWOL. So make sure we ain't got nothing going on there. See about flipping this over and sticking it back in the hole. Yep. And we're going to go forward with this. And this has got to wiggle over. This has got to wiggle up. That's got to drop down. And now all the pegs are locked in. Just going to double check. They're not down. Couple of the screws are bound up. Probably gotta get this worked in just a little bit tighter. That's gonna go up there. Yep, someone's definitely been in here before. Now the problem that I got right at this moment is getting this intake tube on back on the throttle body. Put that right there. Hopefully it'll stay. There we go. That's finally made it on there. I'm gonna snap these things back on. Oh boy. Snap these back on. Get those clips in there after they're locked in far enough. I got to get me some lights, people. Got to get me some lights. There we go. That's that. Now I'm blind. Now I had a hose over here. And taking it off, you see there's little knots right there. You got to pull it up and then pull it back. Gotta hope I went the right way with this, and I think I did. I guess I can put it on there now. Yep. Maybe I shouldn't. They kind of need to be started on both ends before locking them in. Play around them wire retainers because one of them's broke. That one's fine. Plugging the map sensor up back there. Push the latch in. There's a Christmas tree retainer for the wiring harness back here. I gotta get lined up. There's a good one. It's over there. Okay then. Plug the throttle body back up. Nice little clip there. Finish running these down finger tight. Then I'll go look up the spec on them. Seems a little strange to me that that's as snug as it is. Tightening sequence says, or the tightening specs say that we need to tighten it down to 89 inch pounds, just like we did the fuel rails, and then go another 45 degrees after that on the second stage. And we start here, and go here, and I'm going to do this probably in three or four stages. I want to make sure everything is sitting just right. looks like it is. Ouch. Yeah, I gotta slide back down and get this set back up. This one, right? So that's the means this one's next, and then this one now. Okay, that's that. Now we're going to do the torque wrench side of it. Okay, now it wants us to do 45 degrees, so up here would be 90. That would be about 45. I should get a degree wheel, but that should be about 45. Okay, now last step is I'm gonna push that back on. That's back in and tighten that down now. I believe that was a 7 millimeter.